The first sign is accordion sign. It is a specific CT finding in Clostridium difficile induced pseudomembranous colitis due to marked colonic wall thickening, which appears like the folds of a musical instrument, that is accordion. It can also be seen in colonic wall edema secondary to cirrhosis and in ischemic colitis. Second sign is apple core sign. This is classically seen in case of colon carcinoma. On barium examination, there is annular constriction of the colon with overhanging edges and shouldered margins which resemble core of a eaten apple. Next sign is arrowhead sign. This is seen in acute appendicitis. On CT scan, there is focal cecal wall thickening with contrast material in the cecal lumen, assuming a arrowhead configuration, which is pointing towards the thickened and inflamed appendix. Next sign is bird's beak sign. This is classically seen in a case of achalasia cardia because there is dilated proximal esophagus with smooth tapering of the distal esophagus due to impaired relaxation of the distal esophageal sphincter. When there is secondary achalasia due to carcinoma of esophagus, it shows an irregular tapering, which is called rat tail appearance. Next sign is Karaman meniscus sign. This is seen in malignant gastric ulcer. When large ulcer crater with heaped up edges traps the lentiform shaped barium with convexity towards the lumen, giving the appearance of a meniscus, and it is named after the radiologist Karaman. Next sign is the central dot sign. This is seen in Caroli's disease or type 5 colidocal cyst. There is multifocal dilatation of intrahepatic bile ducts with enhancing central dot, which represents the portal vein. Caroli's disease is also associated with medullary sponge kidney and polycystic kidney disease. Next sign is a coffee bean sign. This is classical X-ray sign seen in sigmoid volvulus. There is a massively dilated bowel loop which is ahostral. So this is seen in sigmoid volvulus, and this is also known as kidney bean sign or a bent inner tube sign. The other signs which can be seen in sigmoid volvulus are: there is the overlapping of the liver, there is overlapping of the left flank, there is overlapping of the pelvis. So these are called hepatic left flank and pelvic overlap signs. And now if we perform a barium enema in the case of a sigmoid volvulus, the barium will stop at the point of volvulus, giving a bird's beak or bird of prey beak sign. Very important question, the Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. You can remember the signs of Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis with a mnemonic, that is CROSND. C for cobblestone appearance, comb sign, creeping fat sign, rose sign, ram's horn sign, string sign of canter. S and D, that is pseudo diverticulae, and S is skip lesions. In case of ulcerative colitis, that is LCERAT, lead pipe colon, collar button ulcer. Earliest sign is granular mucosa, reflux ileatus, ahostrations, thumb printing, pseudopolyps, and contiguous involvement. Now the next sign is a collar button ulcer. These are deep ulcerations classically seen in active ulcerative colitis. Now there is a large ahostral segment of the bowel, that is large colon, with multiple ulcerative lesions projecting away from the lumen. A closer look will show that they have narrow neck and a wide base. Narrow neck and a wide base which resembles the button of a collar. So this is a collar button sign seen in ulcerative colitis. Next is the cobblestone appearance. This is seen in active Crohn's disease. It is due to extensive deep fissuring ulcers which surround the inflamed thickened mucosa and resemble the cobblestone. Next sign is colon cutoff sign. This sign is seen in acute pancreatitis. It is due to abrupt termination of gas in distended transverse colon at the level of splenic flexure. The other signs seen are the renal halo sign, sentinel loop sign. Remember, the investigation of choice in acute pancreatitis is CECT abdomen and modified CTSI is used. Next sign is comb sign. This is also seen in Crohn's disease. It is because of hypervascularity of the mesentery with prominent vasa recta and perivascular inflammation which resembles the teeth of a comb. This is the thickened bowel wall seen in Crohn's disease with prominent vasa recta. Remember, it can also be seen in lupus mesenteric vasculitis also. Next sign is corkscrew sign or rosary bead or shish kebab sign. This is seen in diffuse esophageal spasm. It is due to simultaneous non-peristaltic contractions of the esophagus, which resembles the corkscrew. It is double bubble sign. This is seen in duodenal atresia or annular pancreas or lad band in newborns or infants. This is seen on plain x-ray as two air-filled structures representing stomach and duodenum with no air in the distal bubble. Sometimes there can be triple bubble sign, and it is seen in jejunal atresia, which represents the bubble of stomach, the bubble of duodenum, and the bubble of jejunal loops. Next sign is double duct sign. It represents the simultaneous dilatation of CBD and pancreatic duct. It can be seen on MRI, CT scan, ultrasound, and ERCP. And it is seen in cases of CA head of pancreas, periampullary carcinoma, and chronic pancreatitis. This is a MRCP image showing dilated CBD, dilated MPD, which are cut off at this region, giving double duct appearance. Now, another sign which is seen in CA head of pancreas, periampullary carcinoma, and chronic pancreatitis is inverted 3 sign. There is widening of the C loop of the duodenum on barium enema with teetering at the ampulla, giving inverted 3 appearance. Next is football sign. This is seen in massive pneumoperitoneum. There is a large ovoid radiolucency with abdominal cavity outlined by the air. The median umbilical ligament and the falciform ligament, they can be outlined, which form the seams of the rugby ball. The classical sign of pneumoperitoneum is air under the domes of diaphragm. Another sign seen in pneumoperitoneum is the regular sign or double wall sign. There is visualization of both the luminal as well as the extraluminal serosal surface of the bowel due to the accumulation of free air between the bowel loops. Another sign seen in pneumoperitoneum is the cupola sign or small dome or inverted cup sign. Air underneath the central tendon of the diaphragm gives the appearance of a small inverted cup. Next sign is hidebound sign. Hide is animal leather and hidebound is very rigid. So this is seen in scleroderma. They are closely placed valvulae. These are closely placed valvulae conventes seen in the dilated bowel loop in a rigid bowel, which is seen in scleroderma. Next sign is lead pipe colon, that is seen in chronic ulcerative colitis. There is complete loss of ostracens in this large bowel, which appears as a smooth walled cylindrical tube. Now compare with the normal ostral loops of the large colon. Next is the Mercedes-Benz sign. These are the CT scan images showing gallbladder with intraluminal calculi suggestive of cholelithiasis. Now the calculus have central stellate or triradiate appearance of the trapped gas, which gives the Mercedes-Benz sign. Next is the Mexican head sign. This is seen in pedunculated polyp on double contrast barium. It appears as concentric ring with outer ring coating the head of the polyp and inner ring coating the stalk of the polyp, which gives the Mexican head appearance. Next appearance is the bowler head sign. This is seen in sessile polyp. Now this is seen as concentric ring with barium around the base of the polyp and the around the dome of the polyp, which gives the appearance of a bowler's head. Now this bowler's head appearance can also be seen in a diverticulum, but the difference is that diverticulum dome points away from the lumen, whereas in the polyp the bowler's head dome points towards the lumen. Next sign is pseudo-kidney sign. This is seen in intussusception on a sagittal plane on USG. The central echogenic area, which is due to trapped mesentery in a bowel, within a bowel, it resembles the appearance of a normal kidney. So it gives the pseudo-kidney sign. Now another sign which is seen on intussusception on ultrasound is the donut appearance. There is concentric bowel loop within the bowel loop with entrapped mesenteric fat, giving the donut sign. Now on barium enema, remember barium enema is the gold standard in intussusception because it is diagnostic as well as therapeutic procedure. On barium enema, there is a claw sign Another sign which can be seen is coiled spring sign. So interception, pseudo kidney sign, donut sign, claw sign and a coiled spring sign. Next is ram's horn sign. This is also called pseudo Billyroth appearance, seen in Crohn's disease of stomach, as it particularly affects the enterum. Now there is a funnel shaped gastric deformity which resembles the horns of a big horned sheep called ram. Now next is sawtooth appearance. This is seen in diverticulosis. This is a barium examination showing multiple diverticulae giving sawtooth appearance in the sigmoid colon. Next is string of beads or pearl sign. This is seen in small bowel obstruction. On plain x-ray abdomen, there is obliquely oriented row of multiple small gas bubbles giving string of beads appearance. This is also seen in chronic pancreatitis, which is called beaded or chain of lake appearance because of alternating stenosis and dilatation of main pancreatic duct, which is seen on ERCP or MRCP image. This is a MRCP image showing large dilated main pancreatic duct with alternating stenosis and dilatation giving string of beads or pearl sign. Now this is also seen in PCOD on ultrasound and in fibromuscular dysplasia. Next is string sign of Cantor. On barium studies, there is string-like appearance of the contrast-filled bowel loop because of its sphere narrowing. This is seen in Crohn's disease. There is long segment, marked luminal narrowing of the terminal ileum, secondary to inflammation, fibrosis and spasm. This is also seen in hypertrophic pyloric stenosis due to thickened elongated pylorus with a narrow lumen. The other signs seen on hypertrophic pyloric stenosis are the diamond sign, beak sign, shoulder sign, mushroom sign, the double track sign and the teat sign. The investigation of choice in hypertrophic pyloric stenosis is ultrasound, where the length of the involved segment is more than 16 mm, thickness should be more than 4 mm and diameter should be more than 13 mm. Now the last sign is the whirlpool sign. This is seen in midgut volvulus on ultrasound or CT scan. There is swirling pattern of the bowel loops and the superior mesenteric vein as they wrap around the superior mesenteric artery. Now other signs seen in volvulus or malrotation is the corkscrew sign. Now in malrotation, the distal duodenum and the jejunum, instead of crossing the midline, they pass in the inferior direction, which results in the characteristic corkscrew appearance. Thank you.